Hello learners, happy learning. In this video we are going to see the workings of average due date on two different preferred payment date. So here the following amounts are due to X by Y. Y wants to pay off option 1 on 18th March, option 2 14th July. The rate of interest is 8% per annum is considered for this problem. So due date is given, amount is given. So determine the amount to be paid in option A and option B. This is the preferred date. Two different preferred dates are given. So here in this problem, 26th January is a Republic Day and 18th of August is Sunday. So the gazetted holidays is given in the due dates. So you have to consider, if it is a gazetted holiday, you have to take one day prior. So 26th January, you have to take 25th of January. 18th of August, you have to take, consider as 17th of August. So due dates is given and you have to kind of take so this is the Republic Day and due date given in the problem and you have to consider this is the Republic Day and this is the Sunday gazetted holiday. Then you have to take one day prior. So 25th of January and this is 8 instead of 18 you have to take 17. Okay, and amount is we already taken. Now you have to calculate days, number of days from base date. So base date is nothing but the earliest date. So earliest date is 10th of January. So take 10th of January as a zero. From 10th of January to 25th of January, how many days? 15 days. Okay, from 10th of January to 23rd of March. So here the calculation is, in January, total number of days is 31 days. So you deduct this 10, remaining is 31. February, 28 days. So March up to 23rd, 72 days. The next is from 10th of January to 17th of August. 17th of August. So up to 17th of August, you have to calculate the number of days. In January, remaining days is 21 days. So okay, February, 28 days. March, 31. April 30, May 31, June 30 days, July 31, August 17 days, total number of days is 219. Next is you have to calculate product. So product 0 into 500, 0, 15 into 1000, 72 into 3000, 219 into 4000. So the total product, this is the total product and this is the total amount. So here average due date is equal to base data plus total product divided by total amount. So total product is 11,07,000 and total amount is 8,500. So 130 days. So add from 10th of January to add 130 days, you can find the average due date. So here 130 plus 10 is 140 days. January 31 days subtract, February 28 days subtract, March 31 days subtract, April 30 days subtract, remaining is the 20th. So May 20 is the average due date. If you pay on 20th May rupees 8,500 rupees, then you no need to pay any interest and you no need to receive any discount. If you pay beyond this date, then you have to pay interest. If you pay earlier of this average due date and you are eligible to get a discount, that is a rebate. In this problem, two preferred data given. First is 18th March. First one is a preferred date is 18th March. 18th March, it means you are paying earlier than the average due date. You are paying earlier than the average due date. So here, you have to calculate the number of days. Okay, 18th March date to, this is the average due date. This is a preferred date of payment. And this is the average due date. So you have to find out the number of days between this data. So here, the remaining date is 13 and April 30 days up to 20th May. So total number of days is 63 days. So you have to calculate interest, that is a discount. So 8,500 into 8% is given in the problem, multiplied by 63 days. Here 63 days. divided by 365. So in here 365 days. So yeah, the value is 117.37 rupees. If you are paying the amount earlier than average due date க்கு முன்னாடியே நீங்க அமௌண்ட்டை பே பண்றேன்னு விரும்புனீங்கனா, then you need to pay 8500 minus 117 rupees 0.37. So you have to pay only 8382.63 paisa. Okay, average due date க்கு முன்னாடியே நீங்க பே பண்ண விரும்பலாம். இதே நீங்க average due date க்கு அப்புறமா பே பண்றதா இருந்தா 14th July is the preferred date of payment, second option. அப்போ என்ன பண்ணா, இது வந்து ஆவரேஜ் டூ டேட். நீங்கள் பே பண்ண விரும்புறது வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா 14th July. ஸோ இன் பிட்வீன் ஹவு மெனி டேஸ்ன்னு சொல்லி நீங்கள் கால்குலேட் பண்ணுறீங்க. அப்போ 20th மேல ரிமைனிங் இருக்கிறது வந்து 11 டேஸு, ஜூனில் வந்து 30 டேத்து, நெக்ஸ்ட் ஜூலையில் வந்து நீங்கள் பே பண்ண விரும்புறது வந்து 14 டேஸ். அப்போ டோட்டல் வந்து 55 டேஸ். அப்போ இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் கால்குலேட் பண்ணுறது வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா 8500 மல்டிப்ளைட் பை 8% இன்ட்டு 55 டிவைடட் பை 365 102.46. நீங்கள் பே பண்ண வேண்டியது 8500 ருபீஸ் ப்ளஸ் நீங்கள் ஆவரேஜ் டியூ டேட்டுக்கு அப்புறமா நீங்கள் வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா பே பண்ண போகிறீங்க. உங்களுடைய ப்ரிஃபர்டு டேட் வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ஆவரேஜ் டியூ டேட்டுக்கு அப்புறமா நீங்கள் பே பண்ணுறதுனால இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் வந்து ஆட் பண்ணிக்கணும். அப்போ வந்து நீங்கள் பே பண்ண வேண்டியது வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா 8602 ருபீஸ் 0.46 ருபீஸ். இது வந்து பார்த்தீங்கன்னா டிஸ்கவுண்ட்டு இயர்லியராக நீங்கள் பே பண்ணுறீங்க. ஆவரேஜ் டியூ டேட்டுக்கு முன்னாடியே நீங்கள் வந்து இயர்லியராக பே பண்ணும் போது நீங்கள் வந்து என்ன பண்ணுவீங்க, யூ ஆர் எலிஜிபிள் ஃபார் டிஸ்கவுண்ட் ஆர் ரிபீட். இஃப் யூ ஆர் பேயிங் beyond the average due date, then you have to pay interest.